Welcome, my dear students of class 8A and 8B. Today's points, as mentioned in the board. First point, Aurangzeb's policies. What policy Aurangzeb made? What policies Aurangzeb framed and for which Aurangzeb made himself unpopular ruler of our country? Now I am going to discuss about it. Aurangzeb was a ruler, realized that India was a country of different communication, of different opinions, different sentiments, different religious fervors. So it should be united under one umbrella. What his predecessors felt, what his predecessors understood, Aurangzeb could not understand. Initially, the role Aurangzeb played as a ruler was good. There was no defect found in his characters and in his activities. But after a few years later, Aurangzeb suddenly made himself change. And Aurangzeb forgot that it was a country of Hindu majority people. Aurangzeb forgot everything and stopped adopting the policy of equality and adopted the policy of inequality. And hence, Aurangzeb's policy of religious intolerance made almost all Indian regional kingdoms to be his enemies. They all declared themselves independent and stopped paying taxes and revenues. They started collecting and taxes and revenues from their respective states and spent it for the welfare of their states, but not for the welfare of the state or welfare of the country. Before Akbar, it had been the rules for the governor to collect taxes and revenues to pay themselves and the balance to the emperor of Delhi. But Akbar ordered that all taxes should be paid into the royal treasury. And that system was followed by Jahangir, followed by, you know, Shahjahan, but it was not followed by Aurangzeb. Why? Because Aurangzeb was an arrogant ruler, an adamant ruler. What he understood, he tried to utilize it by hook or by crook, whether it was right or wrong. That's why the policy of Aurangzeb made himself unpopular one, and hence he could not achieve success. Aurangzeb, you know, Aurangzeb's Deccan policy, you know, was one of the most important mistake Aurangzeb committed. He needed a source of income to fund his Deccan expedition. So after 20 years of his reign, Aurangzeb imposed the jizya. After 20 years of his reign, Aurangzeb, from the first 20 years, did not impose jizya. He did not want to displease the Hindus. But it was due to financial crisis, Aurangzeb was compelled to impose jizya tax on the non-Muslims, which was a tax on non-Muslims, and this alienated the Hindus and led to a lot of discontentment throughout the country. But according to some historians, Aurangzeb was compelled to impose jizya tax because of financial trouble and crisis. But Aurangzeb, you know, did it at the time when the situation was beyond control. So the Hindu people got very much, you know, displeased with the Aurangzeb policy, Aurangzeb wrong policy. So Aurangzeb, you know, made all the regional kingdoms to be his enemies. For example, Marathas, Jats, Bundelas, Sikhs, they all declared themselves independent. And as a result, a number of wars took place between the Mughals and the regional kingdoms. It had a negative impact on the army and the stability of the Mughal Empire. Ultimately, what happened? As he could hardly concentrate on the administrative measure and needs of the empire, it even destroyed trade in the Deccan. The Rajput chiefs and their military assistants were of great importance to the Mughals ever since the days of Akbar. Aurangzeb's aggression towards the Rajputs led to the loss of Rajput faith, Rajput support and allegiance. You know, the Rajputs once upon a time gave their best efforts, best service for the Mughal Empire. But when? During the time of Emperor Akbar. Akbar gained faith of the Rajputs. Akbar adopted the matrimonial policy and married one Rajput princess. Akbar gained faith. Akbar appointed so many Rajputs as officials in his administration. And hence, the rule of Akbar had become famous because of the cooperation of all regional kingdoms. But Aurangzeb did not care for it. And as a result, there was no cooperation came from any regional kingdom for Aurangzeb. And next point, wrong system of collective revenue. Next point, agrarian economic crisis. What is agrarian economic crisis? In the 18th century, with the decline of the Mughal authority and increasing pressure, the Zagir system was declining. Agricultural economy began to face problems. Since the nobles' Zagirs were transferred recurrently, they had no interest in following a long-term policy for agricultural development. Taxation rates kept rising and the burden of the peasantry increased. As a reaction to the exploitation, the peasants and farmers refused to pay the revenue. They had no option but to protest, and this led to many peasant revolts during the reign of Aurangzeb. It happened. Aurangzeb could not satisfy the needs and expectations of the peasants and farmers. There was no facilities for harvest, but taxes were imposed. He increased taxes and revenues. As a result, peasants and farmers stopped paying taxes and revenues. So it was a great, mistake of Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb was forced to do it, and as a result, agrarian and economic crisis he had to face. And next one, wrong system of collective revenues. The revenues which were being collected by the revenue official, by Aurangzeb, non-cooperative. Neither they could hear the peasants and farmers, their problems, their crisis, nor they could, solution. So that peasants and farmers must pay taxes and revenues. They all were very much arrogant, like Aurangzeb, and they immediately demanded revenues and taxes. And as soon as peasants and farmers failed to pay it, they humiliated them, they pressured them, they made pressure on them. As a result, peasants and farmers became, furious, became aggressive, and hence there was violence. Violence took place between the peasants and farmers and the revenue collectors. The revenue collectors were forced to get back. So they got back without having any good collection of revenues and farmers from the peasants and farmers. So this is a wrong system of collecting revenues and taxes from the business and farmers, Aurangzeb introduced. Aurangzeb administration, that is, in the administration of Aurangzeb, everything was going wrong. That's why Aurangzeb had no other option to find out any substitution, so that business and farmers must pay taxes and revenues satisfactorily, and he could earn money, he could protect the interest of the of his kingdom, interest of his empire, and could fight against the regional kingdoms. Next point, non-cooperation of masses. You know, masses did not cooperate with the Mughals. Earlier, the masses had become a pillar of success for the Mughal rulers, because the masses became prosperous, rich, wealthy. There was no inequality in the country. People led a very rich and prosperous life. There was no unhappiness among them. People were happy. People were overconfident. People had gained respect for the Mughals. The Mughals realized that it was due to their policy they would be able to gain faith of the Indians and establish a strong dynasty, establish a strong rule, establish a strong empire throughout the country. But the rule of Aurangzeb, the entire system of governance. It was the rule of Aurangzeb, the entire system of governance changed. Aurangzeb failed to handle it. As a result, you know, many, many religious leaders of different communities of India, they refused to accept Aurangzeb to be their ruler. They refused to accept Aurangzeb to be their ruler. On the contrary, they started non-cooperating with the Mughal emperor. That's why everywhere there was inequality, everywhere there was non-cooperation from the masses. Masses became violent, they became aggressive. As a result, so many peasants' revolts took place, so many local revolts took place, and moreover, you know, regional kingdoms, they all declared themselves independent and stopped paying taxes and revenues. They collected taxes and revenues and spent it for their own purpose. And Aurangzeb felt very much sorry, insulted. And as a result, Aurangzeb decided to teach the Marathas a good lesson, because he considered the Marathas to be his great enemies. Because these were Marathas who also provoked other regional kingdoms. That's why he decided to crush the revolts of the Marathas and decided to stay at Deccan for a term of 20 years. But it was of no use. He was unable to crush the influence of the Marathas. Financial crisis also had become a great factor. Although he appointed Murshid Quli to be the Diwan of Bengal, our state, and Murshid Quli started collecting taxes and revenues from our state, Bengal, and started sending to the Mughal court every year regularly. Yet, Aurangzeb failed to achieve success against the Marathas. The Marathas destroyed so many forts of the Mughals. They, you know, occupied many, many forts of the Mughals, territories of the Mughals. Aurangzeb tried his level best to get it back, but sometimes he got back it, sometimes once, sometimes the Marathas, once again recaptured it. So this kind of guerrilla warfare method, which was followed by the Marathas, made Aurangzeb very much upset, and hence Aurangzeb had faced a lot of problems and spent a lot of money for crushing the revolts of the Marathas. Up to this, my dear students, next day the remaining points. And before finishing this class, I would like to convey one message to you that this lesson is very easy. But while conducting today's live class, I found some students passed wrong answers. Why? Because they are not attending live class. They are not attending live class. They are not joining live classes properly. They are not joining. They are not following live classes, you know, online classes properly. That's why, my dear students, following online classes is very important, and joining live classes also is very important. So don't be negligent. If you do it, so then you will be able to answer as confidently as possible, like other boys and other girls. But some, a very less number of students, they are practicing it. My dear students, you don't practice it. You attend live classes properly, join live classes properly, you know, online classes properly. If you have any problem, ask me questions during my live class. I shall solve your questions, solve your problems. But don't be negligent. Do your studies. After this, my dear students, thank you.